kick it and go. We step on, spin move, and zones go. Off the sideline, a touchdown, I put on a show. Kick it and go. I had to kick off, kick off and go. Kick it and go. I had to kick off, kick off and go. We step on, spin move, and zones go. Off the sideline, a touchdown, I put on a show. Kick it and go. I had to kick off and go. Kick it and go. I had to kick off, kick off and go. Running it back, never a cap, out of the draft. Watch me bow, soon as I snap, hit it. Wop for the sack, shaking them out, breaking them out, talking my talk, walking my wall like I do. Sit on the throne, get in the zone, turn it on, must be the shoes. Must be the team, must be the camp, must be the crew. You need to win, who need to win, that's all we do. I've been a king and I've been about mine, never could doubt mine. They running the route, I leave an outline when I hit them.
Don't tell me to relax, I can't, I'ma say. Got a new press, those and the J's in the way. Got a new wristwatch, ready, don't take time.
It is always a celebration here in New Orleans, and we are just outside of the French Quarter at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Detroit Lions and the New Orleans Saints. Takes this about 5 yards deep, and he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. receiver turned into a runner, and then he turned into a fumbler, and it goes the other way for six.
I love your description. Although for the offense, they're not too happy about it, but for the defense, what a big-time play for them. Never give up on anything. Sometimes you create your own points.
But the receiver, hard to fault him. He's just going for extra yards.
That's exactly what you're supposed to do, but you have to take care of the football.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25.
Now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's a quick throw left side to start things out. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. With these run-pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Operating from the gun, Patterson. And now the ball's out. Talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it, and not realizing that danger lurks while you're doing so, and there's your end result right there.
Ty Johnson.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
46-yard line. A gain of four. It's now second and six.
Looking to throw. Patterson. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So now it's third and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. From the gun, Patterson, into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
A good starting spot for the Saints as they come up first and 10 at their 38. After the interception, here's Jackson. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll bring up a second down.
Out of bounds at the 44-yard line. It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
From the gun, it's Jackson. And he's got his man on the out route. 20, 10, touchdown, New Orleans. Big play there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Saints are able to strike quickly for six. the kick early on. They have all facets of the game working in tandem.
Yeah, you get the defensive touchdown early to give you the first score, and then your offense piggybacks on top of that and gets their own. And any coach we've ever talked to, and we've had that conversation with them prior to the game, they always say, you know, if we can score on defense or special teams, that gives like a 95% chance of winning the game. I don't know if that number's correct, but it certainly does tend to play out that way, doesn't it?
It does. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. They've got his man complete. They're able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. That one good for 37 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Here's Johnson. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up. In need of a conversion on 3rd down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off around the 27. 30. 10. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. And his kick is right through.
Saints 21, Lions nothing.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. And the Saints signal for another timeout. And that's their 2nd charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to 1 remaining. Start the drive on the ground with Johnson. He'll have a 1st down past the 40. And down right around the 37. A big pickup of 38.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So in Saints territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 37-yard line. Back to throw. Patterson, screen play, Johnson. Johnson, oh, it's pick 3, football's out. And this is picked up by the Saints. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football. And they still find ways to knock it free.
They go over the middle, and it's complete to start the drive. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
At the 37-yard line.
From the gun, Jackson steps away to his left. He's going to take off with it, and he goes out right around the 39. When in doubt, do it yourself as he keeps it for 3 and a 1st down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his 2nd read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the 1st down.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Operating from the gun, Huntley. Away. It's incomplete. Darnell Mooney, the target there. And that'll bring up second down.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver. But a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise. And he was able to bat it away.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 14 on that one, and a first down. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead him to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing
Jadeveon Clowney there on the stop.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive. We couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
From the 45 on second down, Jackson. And a throw right sideline is complete. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flag. Marched off on the face mask. Here's first and 10. Jackson from the shotgun. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
After the incomplete. To throw again. Jackson. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against it.
On third down, Jackson. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
Straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. Jackson will throw again. And it's caught. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And it'll be a turnover on downs. To throw from his end zone. Patterson. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open.
Open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice, get rid of it, live to fight another down.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. On the ground, this is Johnson. Able to bust through the tackle, but not much to show for it. Still inside the five. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead.
Gain on the play. Brings up third down.
Nothing. Our score after one.
Score Saints 21, Lions nothing.
Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. And that will be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league?
Oh, had to get it out quickly. Be a safety. And the safety there, another mistake, and these mistakes just keep piling up.
How many more can they make? They put themselves in such a massive hole now, going to be difficult to dig out from under.
Yeah, for sure they can't afford any more at this point. play fake. Here's Jackson. Flushed out right. Looking left side. It's complete. He's got it. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Second and 11 now. From the gun, Jackson. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Well, maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up, a little bit of a jolt. One of the few things has gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. Here's Jackson on third and long. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he is finally out of bounds all the way down at the 30. A big play there on the catch and run. 49 yards. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
Now this pass into the hands of Saquon Barkley. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. That one a gain of 20 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 10-yard line.
And Jackson throwing once more. And he's got it. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. From 10 yards out. And the Saints are pouring it on. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now?
I would say so. And they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. They were looking for Johnson that time. That'll bring up second down. Throwing again. Patterson. And he gets this one to Ridley complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. They'll run it with Johnson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
A gain of 11 on the play. And the Lions first down.
Now Johnson. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And they'll go jet sweep to try to pick it up. Well, he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. He'll get a dozen there, and the Lions have a first down.
I think the reason that this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, But how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Operating from the gun, Patterson. This is caught, and he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one.
First and goal.
A good pickup there, 26 yards. They'll run it with Johnson, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Ty Johnson, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Lions are able to cut into this lead.
I'm not sure that they have illusions right now of, okay, we're going to score eight times in a row. We're going to be terrific. But to get one, that was huge for them. That has to feel much better right now.
And you do have, we're still in the first half. You do have the entire second half. It's something about that goose egg that just looked bad on that board, but now they've broken it.
Yeah, broken through. Can they maintain the pace? We'll see as we go along.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
And 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started.
Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why?
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. To throw again, Jackson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. He's going to look deep down. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A big play there. 59 yards. And the Saints just continue to roll. Now he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Lions 7.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Takes this about 5 yards deep, and he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 2.
Brings up 2nd and 2.
Johnson. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
8 yards first down as they're able to convert.
8 yard pickup. First down, Lions.
They'll hand it off now. Johnson. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 3.
Tackle made right at midfield. It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
Now a handoff. Johnson. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half.
First down.
runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. From the gun, Patterson. And it is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here. The intended target was Calvin Ridley. And now it's second down. Throwing again, Patterson. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And it's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. Now play number 7 of the drive as you're looking at a 3rd and 10.
And 10 yards to go.
Operating from the gun, Patterson. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now.
Intended for Calvin Ridley. Incomplete. It's now 4th down.
The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on 4th and 10. From the gun, Patterson. That's to his running back, complete. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. The Lions turned away on 4th down. And the Saints will have the football back. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
Dixon set to kick off.
Set now to go for the 3rd quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. This is taken just shy of the 10. And takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26.
At their own 26-yard line.
No pain, no gain.
Now Jackson on 1st down. This will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
2nd and 10. Here's Jackson again. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 5 catches for him in that first half, and that's number 6 that we just saw, and also a 1st down. Now Saquon Barkley. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. He was trying to clear the way, and the big fullback instead he gets a hold.
And you don't see that very often on running plays from those guys because usually they're the lead blocker. Normally when he gets caught, it's in a passing situation.
Now it's Jackson. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like he'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It's a great 14 yards, but not enough for the 1st down due to the previous penalty. The
yard line.
From midfield now, here's Jackson. He's going to float this one deep right side. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. To begin this second half.
And just think about the time you spent in the locker room going over what you expected to do in the second half. Not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up. You find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live, and now they've got to find a way out of this hole.
2 yards, the loss, 2nd and 12.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
Looking to throw on second down. Patterson, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Operating from the gun, Patterson. And for the third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. So cancel the interception, pass interference.
And you know what else gets canceled? The return yardage. Makes the play, but now it's all for naught.
The busy night continues for Johnson. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. They go to Johnson again. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
Brings up third down.
Looking to throw, Patterson. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 39, and he'll take it across midfield and down the 48-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second-half blowout material.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. From the gun, Jackson. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49.
The tackle made back at his own 49.
To throw is Jackson. Throwing on third and long. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 23. Operating from the gun, Jackson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down.
First down.
From the gun, Jackson. This will be caught about the 5. And I think the ball's out. And this is scooped up by the Lions. Two words that we hear coaches say all the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
After the fumble recovery, it's Jackson. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints.
John L. Mooney.
His second touchdown on the season. And the Saints take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash in for six. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter.
44, Lions 7.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Fielded in the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Here's a 20th carry for Johnson. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. A gain of five, good enough for the first down. Final minute now of the third quarter.
First down, Lions.
The first down carry here for Johnson. And they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
No gain on
that time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
And his throw here is incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over him.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
On the deep ball.
Now here's Michael Dixon on for his second punt, and remember, his first one was blocked. A 40-yard punt, 1 yard on the return, and the Saints will take over with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start...
And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter.
Bring it!
That's the end of the third quarter.
One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson from across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown.
Zane Gonzalez lining up for the extra point.
This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football, because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they just get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
Pulls it in at the 13. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
And 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense.
And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, he commentated on three games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game, and that's always puzzled me a little bit.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Play action. It's Jackson. That is incomplete. Force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. So now third and 10. A big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Again, Jackson. And he comes back with one complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Another catch for him. He's over the 250-yard mark now for the game, and he's got another first down. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. To throw again. Jackson. Ebron caught left side. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 20-yard line.
First and 10.
A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. This will be caught inside the 10.
And the Saints are going to be set up with a first and goal here as the tackle made at the 9.
Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
First and goal at the 9-yard line.
They go play action with Jackson. And that could be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
When you run into slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
To throw again is Jackson, being chased out left. Here down the stretch, two picks now in the fourth quarter, trying to hang on to that lead.
Talk about keeping someone in the game. Instead of being able to shut the door, it's still cracked open because they can come back on you now. The only people really happy about those picks, any fantasy team that has this defense. And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
Throw there, going to be incomplete.
Another pass attempt, another incompletion, and they're just a little over 100 yards passing here in this game, so defensively, pretty good job.
Definitely, because they were never really able to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, so a lot of credit to the defensive game plan and especially the execution.
And he'll just punch it out of there, and it's not a great kick. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Saints will have a short field in front of them. They take over here, first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
that was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete. And that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
Jackson on third down. And that is incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Just 21 yards on the punt there, and the Lions will take over.
22-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat. And down to the 15. A big run there by Johnson. 62 yards on that last run. He's now hit the 6,000-yard mark for rushing yards in his career.
And moves him squarely into the top 100 rushers of all time. In fact, he can boast that he's rushed for over 1,000 yards more than Gale Sayers did in his career. And Gale Sayers was a Hall of Famer in a short career.
They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of 2. On second down, Johnson.
And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7.
It's a gain of a yard, and it's 3rd down.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he does get in for 6.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. Now he's doing his part, but still facing a sizable deficit.
And he would like to do more, but he needs help from the other 2/3, right? He needs his defense to bow up a little bit, and he also needs special teams to maybe create some big plays and help them get back in it.
This is taken just shy of the 10. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. They're looking at a 3rd straight win here if they can hold on. Throwing now, Jackson on 1st down. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. 1st down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 10 yards, good for a Saints 1st down. Oh, Jackson's going to throw it. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
A 6-yard pickup.
And that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on 1st down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a 2nd and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Jackson, that's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. Flew past 200, 300, 400 yards. Now he's over 450 yards passing on the day.
So what you're saying is oxygen for everyone catching the ball and trying to defend?
Yeah, especially those guys trying to defend right now.
No doubt.
Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And this is scooped up by the Lions. He's at the 40. Past the 20.
He let one slip away last week as well, so now two fumbles lost in as many weeks.
Well, we were out at practice, and we watched him work. And what did his quarterback coach talk about all week?
Being a two-hand monster. He will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Ty Johnson with touchdown number 3 in the game and 6 on the year. And the Lions use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Staying on the field as they're going to try for 2. They'll try and run for it with Johnson. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. So the defense gets the stop. I know it's situation to situation, but who has more pressure there, offense or defense, when they go for 2?
I truly believe it's the defense has more pressure because the offense has an entire playbook wide open from the 2-yard line. You can run it, you can throw it. So defensively, I think most teams are going to be aggressive and force the issue and try and bring pressure.
22-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And 3 timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show.
Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
And incomplete. Brings up 2nd and 10 at the 40-yard line.
So 2nd down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Throwing again. Jackson, and that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. From the gun, it's Jackson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And you definitely could make the case we might not even be in overtime had he not thrown 3 interceptions in regulation. But looking better here so far, no team.
Yeah, and when you think about what a coach is thinking at that point, because normally you've thrown 3 picks during the game, you might craft your play calling to be a little more careful. Not in this case. The green light still on for him.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaunt. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. The Saints are winners here as we say so long from New Orleans.
Designer, drip, little bit, little bit.